Welcome to the broadcast service for the United Parish of Killinchy, Kilmood and Tullnakill. This week we explore the theme of being glad in the house of the Lord. Our opening hymn is the hymn version of the canticle Jubilate, based on Psalm 100. The Collect for the 14th Sunday after Trinity. Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, give unto us the increase of faith, hope, and charity, and that we may obtain that which Thou dost promise, make us to love which Thou dost command. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The psalm appointed for today is Psalm 122, Laetatis Sum. I was glad when they said unto me, We will go to the house of the Lord. Our feet shall stand in thy gates, O Jerusalem. Jerusalem is built as a city that is at unity in itself. For thither the tribes go up, even the tribes of the Lord, to testify unto Israel, to give thanks unto the name of the Lord. For there is the seat of judgment, even the seat of the house of David. O pray for the peace of Jerusalem, they shall prosper that love thee. Peace be within thy walls, and plenteousness within thy palaces. For my brethren and companions' sake, I will wish thee prosperity. Yea, because of the house of the Lord our God, I will seek to do thee good. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever, world without end. Amen. The lesson for today is Luke's Gospel, chapter 2, beginning at the 41st verse. The boy Jesus in the temple. Now his parents went to Jerusalem every year at the feast of Passover. And when he was 12 years old, they went up according to their custom. And when the feast was ended, as they were returning, the boy Jesus stayed behind in Jerusalem. His parents did not know it, but supposing him to be in the group, they went a day's journey. But then they began to search for him among their relatives and acquaintances. And when they did not find him, they returned to Jerusalem, searching for him. After 3 days, they found him in the temple, sitting among the teachers, listening to them and asking them questions. And all who heard him were amazed at his understanding and his answers. And when his parents saw him, they were astonished. And his mother Mary said to him, Son, why have you treated us like this? Behold, your father and I have been searching for you in great distress. And he said to them, Why were you looking for me? Did you not know that I would be in my father's house? They did not understand the saying that he spoke to them. And he went down with them and came to Nazareth and was submissive to them. And his mother Mary treasured up all these things in her heart. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Weddings are always wonderful occasions when family and friends gather together to witness the bride and groom tie the knot. Excitement is in the air as the bride walks down the aisle to meet the groom. The music that accompanies the procession of the bride helps build the anticipation. Everyone has been waiting for this special moment, and when it happens, it brings much joy and happiness. I wonder if any wives here can remember what you walked down the aisle to. Maybe it was the Prince of Denmark's march, or was it Wagner's bridal chorus, "Here Comes the Bride"? Can you remember the music that Kate Middleton walked down the aisle to marry Prince William to? It was Hubert Parry's "I Was Glad". It's one of my favourite settings of Psalm 122. It's so majestic, so awe-inspiring, the hairs literally stand on the back of your neck as you are transported, even transcended, to the city of God, Jerusalem. I was glad when they said unto me, "Let us go to the house of the Lord." Our feet standing within your gates, O Jerusalem. What a way to start a psalm. Full of awe and wonder, full of joy and gladness. The psalmist paints this wonderful picture of the people of faith receiving the invitation to go to the house of the Lord. And this invitation is met with excitement and anticipation. The pilgrims cannot wait to make the journey to Jerusalem to stand within the house of the Lord. From the middle of March until now, I have been unable to invite you to the house of the Lord here in the parish. Due to COVID-19 government restrictions, our daily routine, our weekly rhythm has been disrupted, and even the simple act of going to church requires a health and safety plan and a risk assessment. For 6 months now, we have been unable to gather as the family of faith in this place, and even those of us who do gather in either St Mary's Kilmood or Killinchy Parish Church do so with various measures in place, like hand sanitizer, social distancing, face masks, and not being able to sing. Those of us who are unable to make it to church and who are still at home out of health concerns have to forego meeting physically in church. But be reassured that you are with us in church in spirit, and those of us who gather in church very much think about you at this time. Our prayer is that the prospect of meeting again with us in church will fill your hearts with joy and anticipation. Psalm 122 speaks of the joy and gladness that we experience when we go to the house of the Lord. But why is it a joy to be in the house of the Lord? The psalmist implicitly presents two reasons why it is a joy to be in the house of the Lord. One, to give thanks to the name of the Lord, and two, to pray for peace, security, and prosperity. Firstly, the psalmist says it is good to go to the house of the Lord to give thanks to the Lord. He writes, "Jerusalem built as a city that is bound firmly together, to which the tribes go up, the tribes of the Lord, as was decreed for Israel, to give thanks to the name of the Lord." The people of faith were to make the journey to Jerusalem to give thanks to their God. In doing so, they would enjoy spiritual, social, and mental health benefits. Spiritually, they would be enriched as they were built up in their faith and as they grew in their knowledge of God. Socially, they would enjoy the company of their family and friends and those from the other tribes on the journey. And it was good for their mental health because it reminded them that in life they had good things going for them, that there were things that they could be thankful for. The journey to the house of the Lord was truly a joyous experience as they prepared to give thanks to God for all his blessings to them in life. Well, what about today? What about the here and now? Well, even in the year that is 2020, we have so much to be thankful for. We can thank God for our friends and family members and neighbours who have helped us get through lockdown. We can thank God for the NHS and the various key workers who have served so faithfully on the front line during the pandemic. And we can thank God for our faith that has sustained us through these challenging times, our faith that has kept us going through these difficult times. We have so much to be thankful for, even in this year that is 2020. So let us be like the psalmist. Let us give thanks to God with grateful hearts for all the blessings we have received from his hands and for all of the help and support we have experienced. Secondly, the psalmist says it is good to go to the house of the Lord to pray. He writes, "Pray for the peace of Jerusalem. May they be secure who love you. Peace be within your walls and security within your towers. For my brothers and companions' sake, I will say, peace within you. For the sake of the house of the Lord our God, I will seek your good." The emphasis here isn't just on private, personal prayer, but also on corporate, public prayer. The psalmist isn't just praying for peace, security, and prosperity for himself. He's praying for every member of the community, for brothers, sisters, companions, for all within the gates, that they would have peace, security, and prosperity. This remains a good model for prayer in this day and generation. As the people of faith, we are called to be the people of prayer. We are to pray not just for our own needs, but for the needs of others. That's why in our prayer time, we have time and space for personal, private prayer, as well as corporate, public prayer. We are to pray for all people and all things. Spiritually, this is good for us. We find ourselves refreshed and strengthened as we hand over our thoughts and concerns to God. Socially, it's also good for us because it reminds us of the people who are around us, that we are not alone, that we are all pilgrims on the journey that is called life. And in terms of our mental health, prayer helps us to unburden. It reminds us that we are not alone in our struggles, that the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob is with us. No wonder the Bible says, "Cast all your cares on him, for he cares for you." So this morning, let us be like the psalmist. Let us be glad in the house of the Lord. Let us give thanks for all of his blessings to us in life. And let us pray for our needs and the needs of people around us. And as we do so, may the Lord grant us his peace, his security, and his prosperity. Amen.
Before the throne of God above, I have a strong, a perfect plea, a great high priest whose name is love, whoever lives and pleads for me. My name is written on his hands, my name is hidden in his heart. I know that while in heaven he stands, no power can force me to depart, no power can force me to depart. When Satan tempts me to despair and tells me of the guilt within, upward I look and see him there who made an end to all my sin. Because the sinless Savior died, my sinful soul is counted free. For God the just is satisfied to look on him and pardon me, to look on him and pardon me. Behold him there, the risen Lamb, my perfect sinless righteousness, the great unchangeable I am, the King of glory and of grace. One with my Lord I cannot die, my soul is purchased by his blood, my life is safe with Christ on high, with Christ my Savior and my God, with Christ my Savior and my God.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we pray for your church throughout the world. Grant that every member of your church
may truly and humbly serve you. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world, that there may be justice and peace on the earth. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. We pray for your people. Give us grace to do your will in all that we undertake, that your glory may be proclaimed in our lives. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. We pray that you would have compassion on those who suffer from grief or trouble, that they may be delivered from their distress. We name to you those who are dear to us. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. And in a time of silence, we bring our own needs and the needs of those around us to your throne of grace. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Gracious God, grant that the desires of your people's hearts may find favour in your sight through the intercession of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. As our Saviour Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. May God give to you, and to all those whom you love, his comfort and his peace, his light and his joy, in this world and the next. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be upon you and remain with you always. Amen. We hope you have enjoyed our service. We are committed to continuing our online ministry and our CD ministry for those who cannot yet attend church. If you do wish to attend church, there will be a service at St Mary's Kilmood at 10 a.m. and one at 11:30 in Killinchy Parish Church. In order to facilitate track and trace, please contact the wardens about your intention to attend. Stay safe and God bless.